so hungry all the time.
Did you have any luck with those raiders?
I took care of those raiders for you.
Really? Well, that's the best news I've heard in a long time. By the way, we've talked about it, and we've decided to support the Minutemen. I think it's worth giving it another chance. The only way things will get better is if we stand together.
Work to do. Can't talk now.
need assistance. Over. Boston, this is Western Bell. We have no power and we're in very rough seas. Do you copy? Hey, we need help out here. Where the hell is everyone?
This has been a pre-recorded message. Message repeats in 3 seconds.
Mayday, mayday, mayday. This is Merchant Vessel Western Bell. We are in immediate need of assistance. Boston, this is Western Bell. We have no power and we're in very rough seas.
Thank you.
predictable. Imogene is missing, and I want her found.
She's not missing, Mother.
Do you know where she is?
So did you find out what happened to the courier?
Your sister is missing, and I want her found. What else is Edward for, if not to keep the family safe?
Some raiders set up camp near Parsons and ambushed him. I took care of them.
I don't like raiders operating so close to Parsons. I hope this isn't the start of something serious. What about the serum he was carrying? Did you get any of it back?
How dare you speak so disrespectfully about your sister?
The serum was all gone.
Yeah, figures. Oh well, here's your pay for the job. Too bad about the serum. Now, as far as what's next. Oh hell, I guess it's time you met Wilhelmina. Jack's not gonna be happy about it. Come on. Jack, I'll take care of it. Mrs. Cabot, don't worry. I'll send someone to find Imogene.
Thank you, Edward. I can always count on you. Why can't you be as devoted as dear Edward?
You shouldn't indulge her, Edward. It just makes her more impossible to deal with next time.
Just doing my job. Speaking of which, we tracked down the last delivery from Parsons. Raiders got it all, I'm sorry to say.
Oh, that is bad news. Our supply here is dangerously low. Well, we'll just have to make it last until the next delivery.
Imogene is Jack's sister. You probably figured that out yourself. She's, a little flighty. Impulsive. From time to time, she runs off. Usually with a new boyfriend. Then I send somebody to bring her home.
Do you know where she's gone?
No, but it shouldn't be too hard to find out. She's been spending a lot of time in Good Neighbor. At the jazz club there, the third rail. Somebody there must know something. She's not known for keeping her mouth shut.
What if she doesn't want to come home?
Obviously, as one of the family, you can't just knock her in the head and drag her home by her heels. Usually, by the time I send someone after her, she's gotten bored with the whole thing and is ready to come home. I'm sure you'll think of something. You're supposed to be resourceful, remember?
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, The Mystery of Mayor Murphy.
Enjoy your stay. Yeah?
Peace, brother.
Hell of a load you're carrying. Better sell some to Daisy before someone swipes it.
My client appreciates the work you did with his rat problem. Now, if you're buying, let's hear what you want.
Yo, do you know Imogene Cabot?
Name rings a bell. Kind of balmy. Haven't seen her in a while, though. Try Magnolia. She likes to make friends with people. She might know more about this missing bird. Magnolia! This guy wants a word.
Excuse me.
Something I can do for you, Hanson?
Do you know Imogen Cabot?
Imogen? Sure. I know her. I haven't seen her in a while, though. Are you a friend of hers?
She's missing, and her family's worried about her.
Well, I'm glad somebody's looking out for her. She seemed like a body that could use looking after.
Do you know where she's gone?
There was this preacher fella who used to come in here all the time. One of the slick ones. Always going on about remaking your life and so on. Most of the customers wouldn't give him the time of day, but Imogen, she latched on to him for some reason. I don't suppose it hurt that he was easy on the eyes. Intense. Some women find that irresistible. Pam, would you come over here a minute?
Is there a problem, Miss Magnolia?
No, this fine gentleman here was just looking for Imogen. Do you happen to know where that preacher fella came from?
Brother Thomas?
Yes, that's right. The one Imogen was always hanging on.
Had to throw him out. Wouldn't stop bothering customers with that salvation racket. Kept going on and on about joining him at the back bay. Then he'd shove those stupid flyers in your face. Here, kept one of them, just in case he didn't pay his bar tab.
Well, thanks, honey. You were a big help.
Anything for you, miss.
I hope Imogen's all right. I didn't much like the idea of her going off with that preacher fellow. You're looking for me? What can I do for you?
I wouldn't mind hearing a different song.
A good musician listens to her audience. How about this one?
You're becoming quite a regular. Well, the beer still tastes the same. Like shit.
Let's see what you got.
Don't bother tipping. I'm already overcharging you.
Hi.
Galaxy!
Not too close,
News.
Mr. Tough Guy.
Radio!
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode in the Parlor of Mysteries.
Jasmine, chamomile.
Thank you.
Nothing! Nothing!
To Brother Thomas about how to join our movement.
Hey there.
Welcome, neighbor. We're always glad to see a new face around here. Tell me something. You ever feel like this whole world is broken? Do you ever wonder why things can't be the way they were in the good old days?
The whole world is broken.
That's what I used to think. Until I found a way to make a difference, to transform my life, and maybe everyone else's too. We call ourselves the Pillars of the Community. We're a pretty new movement, so you may not have heard of us. But we're growing fast all across the Commonwealth, and you can be part of this exciting future. Step right this way, and I'll be happy to tell you all about our movement and how you can be a part of it.
Sounds good.
Well, that's just fantastic. I know you're going to fit right in around here. Don't be shy. Just follow me. Excited to welcome a new member into our fold. Alrighty, I hope you're as excited as I am. This is one of my favorite parts of the job, getting to welcome new members into our group. The first step is simple. You have to learn to give up your attachment to material possessions in order to gain the ability to have true wealth, health, and happiness. Just go ahead and give me everything you own, and I'll initiate you as a first-level pillar of the community.
I'm actually just looking for Imogene Cabot.
Oh, I'm sorry, but Imogene is indisposed right now. She's not seeing visitors.
What's she doing here? Is she a member of your movement?
Actually, she and I are, you know, romantically involved. Not that it's any of your business, but she and I are just having a little relationship trouble. You know how it is. She's not seeing anybody until she cools off.
I'm a friend of the family. Maybe I can talk some sense into her.
Look, truth is, we had a little, disagreement about her joining the movement. She got kind of violent. So I locked her in there until I could figure out what to do with her. If you're willing to take her off my hands, let me unlock the door for you, and then she's all yours. I've got to warn you, she's way stronger than she looks. It took all of us combined to even get her locked up in there.
The dust-to-oxygen ratio here is...
It's all yours, neighbor.
You must be Imogene.
Don't tell me. Jack sent you.
You're Jack's sister. I was expecting someone a bit... younger.
You really know how to flatter a lady, don't you? Just to be clear, I'm Jack's younger sister. The baby of the family. Once I get home and get some of Jack's serum, I'll be back to my usual stunning self.
Jack has a serum that reverses aging.
It's more like it halts aging. I started taking it when I was 32, so normally that's what I look like. You'll see once I get my treatment. I was well known as one of the belles of Boston society, back when there was any.
What happens if you don't get more serum?
Oh, I don't think we need to worry about that. I've gone without a treatment much longer before with no lasting effect.
I don't care about your beauty treatments. Let's go already.
I don't recall asking you to rescue me.
I'm just here to make sure you're okay.
I'm fine, as you can see. I was just waiting to see if Thomas would come to his senses. But since you've already gone to all this trouble, I may as well leave now. I was bored with Thomas anyway. He seemed so interesting at first. But after we got here, he turned out to be just another brute. He actually thought it could force me to join his absurd cult.
Need anything before we go?
No. I didn't bring anything worth taking with me. Oh, I'm not going with you. You can tell Mother I'll be along home before too long. I just need a drink first.
Hi.
We don't have anything to talk about.
Hey there.
Welcome.
Always looking for new members.
Hey, Jack.
Not now.
Gee, now. How's this?
Oh, that's done it. Edward, what's going on there?
We're under attack. They're inside the building.
Inside? Can you keep them out of the basement?
I'm trying, Jack. I've never seen raiders that... For God's sake, Sammy. The doorway, right there. Sorry. Things are a little busy around here right now.
Listen, if they're inside the building, you have to go to the office and shut down the elevator. You can't risk them getting to Lorenzo.
Got it. Office. Elevator. You better round up whoever you can and get them.
Hello? Edward? Come in! Edward! There's no signal at all. I've lost him.
What's happening, Jack? If these people are inside Parsons, if they free him...
Don't worry, I'll handle it.
I always knew it would end this way. I never should have allowed you to lock up Lorenzo in that place.
That isn't helping, Mother. And as I recall, using the serum was your idea, not mine.
So what are you going to do?
I said I'll handle it. I'm thinking.
Who are you again?
What's going on?
That was Edward. He's at Parsons, the old asylum. They're under attack by raiders. It's strange. The guards have held off raiders before without any trouble. I don't know what's gone wrong this time.
What happened?
The guards at Parsons called in that they were under attack. Edward went to help. I've only just been able to raise him, briefly. I didn't get much, but it sounds like the situation there is nearly out of control. I wonder if these could be the same raiders that stole that last shipment. If some of them had used the undiluted serum, it could explain their unusual success against Edward's men.
What exactly does this serum do?
I suppose it's time you knew. The main benefit of the serum is to halt aging. My family and I are all over 400 years old. But it also confers other side effects, especially in the undiluted form that the raiders stole. It increases strength and resistance to all kinds of physical damage. So at least some of these raiders may be much more dangerous than the ones you're used to dealing with.
Where do you get this serum from?
My father, Lorenzo Cabot, is confined in Parsons. He became dangerously unstable after handling an artifact he found on an archaeological dig in Arabia. He gained various seemingly paranormal powers, as well as becoming increasingly irrational and violent. In the end, I had no choice but to confine him, for his own safety, as well as ours.
Jack, are you sure it's wise telling him all this?
In the course of my attempts to cure him, I discovered that the artifact had introduced anomalies into his blood. So the source of his insanity is also the basis of the treatments that have prolonged all our lives. The irony isn't lost on me, but if he were to escape from Parsons, I would lose my father forever. I will not allow that to happen. Not to mention that the artifact has made him paranoid, homicidally violent, and endowed with extraordinary abilities.
Exactly what abilities does he have?
Enhanced strength, unusual resistance to most kinds of physical damage. Oh, and a kind of local telekinesis, which appears to be projected by the artifact itself. That's why I've built a dampening field into his cell. Which is why we really need to stop these intruders before they turn it off. Hold on, weren't you off looking for Imogene? Did you find her?
Yes, I found her. She's fine.
Oh, good.
At least there's one small comfort on this terrible day.
You'll be wanting to be paid, of course. Edward usually handles these things. Caps is what you use for currency, isn't that right? Here. I hope that's the right amount. Before we go, I need you to understand something. When we get to Parsons, you need to do exactly what I tell you. Nothing more, nothing less. Is that clear?
Why is that so important?
If these intruders have gotten past Edward's men, they may have freed Lorenzo. I'm the only one who understands exactly how to deal with him. Is that clear enough for you?
Got it.
Good.
Make sure you have whatever you'll need for a serious battle. I'll wait for you outside.
Jack, be careful. And try not to hurt him.
I love Father at least as much as you do. But you know as well as I do that if he gets free, there will only be one option.
Don't let it come to that, please.
I'll do my best, Mother. And if Imogene finally comes home, for God's sake, don't let her leave again until I get back. Now I really do have to go.
Oh. What do you want?
If you find any spare parts, you be sure to let me know.
Thank you.
should have done more. I hope those raiders pay for what they've done.
Robot tried to be human.
What are you gonna do?
You ask me, freedom's always worth fighting for.
So, you ready to get this show on the road?
I'll let you know if I hear of any settlements that need our help. In the meantime, make sure to offer help to anyone that needs it. That can only help our cause. I wish I knew what the Institute really wanted up here.
Men seem to have given a good account of themselves. Not good enough, Seth. We need to get to my office. From there we can see how bad things really are. Okay, stick close, follow my orders, and I'm sure everything will be fine. Let's go.